You've probably heard of the password game at some point. Created by Neil Agarwal, it is best known for its absurd rules in password creation. I love how it is so creative in transforming something we use every day into such a fun game. What really stood out to me was that there was something we could learn about passwords and the world of computer security from the game itself. In this video, I will talk about what we can do to design good password systems. To start things off, let's answer the question. Why are these complicated requirements so bad for creating passwords? Well, for one, it offers a horrible user experience. Imagine creating a password for your bank account, and suddenly this pops up. Now you have to go through a seemingly endless list of 35 unique rules, find the best chess move for a given position, and even do a mini GeoGuessr. That would suck a lot, wouldn't it? Modern-day passwords are kind of like this, though much more toned down. We need a mix of alphanumeric characters, capitalization, symbols, and a length requirement. Sometimes, we can't even reuse our old passwords, which starts to make things very complicated. We have all these bunch of requirements that are not designed to make passwords easy for humans to remember, yet it can be cracked within a few days. I think this XKCD comic over here sums it up perfectly. On the other hand, by combining just four simple words, we can create a very strong password. So, why aren't we doing that? A possible reason is that the password is still prone to dictionary attacks. Like the name suggests, dictionary attacks are a form of brute force attack to guess your password by using a list of likely passwords. It is much more focused than a pure brute force attack that attempts all possible permutations of passwords out there. As humans, we might pick words that are correlated to each other, subconsciously forming a pattern. An example would be, Red Bull gives wings. Sure, there are four words in the string, but we all know Red Bull as a brand, and also their catchphrase, Red Bull gives you wings. This password will hence be more vulnerable since you are not fully choosing four independent words due to the correlations. Hence, the trick is to use words that are as random as possible, mixing them in with numbers and special characters. Perhaps something like what Microsoft proposed, Six Monkeys Are Looking. It will most definitely require some creativity though. However, this does not mean that you are completely immune, as hackers have developed ways of substituting numbers for similar-looking letters. There's really no password that is completely safe. We simply do our best to make it difficult for it to be guessed. The password game also prompts us to think about alternatives to traditional text-based passwords. With so many funny rules that test your knowledge on a variety of topics, it really got me thinking. Are traditional text passwords the only way we can authenticate ourselves? Can we borrow the idea from the password game and use rules? Or even try something else? Before we explore that possibility, let's think about what it means to be authenticated. Authentication is actually about proving the identity of a user to a system to see if they are the person they are claiming to be. This is very important as we might allow them to access privileged information or services, such as a bank account. You don't want any random stranger to just transfer money out of there, do you? This is where passwords come in. It serves as a means of authentication due to the unique nature of your password. For example, if a user, Bob, tries to log in into a system, the system only sees a username and password. The fact that only Bob knows the password, assuming that he keeps it confidential and doesn't share it with others, of course, is a good indicator to the system that the person logging in as Bob is really Bob himself. So what other things can fulfill this property? If we use rules like the password game, we immediately run into the issue that multiple passwords can be accepted. Hence, that's out of the question. Instead, there are multiple methods that we are already currently employing which are more feasible. For example, biometrics like Face ID on your iPhone. Your face is one of a kind and is quite a reliable proof of your identity. We also have things like two-factor authentication on top of our passwords. Things like SMS one-time passwords or apps like Microsoft Authenticator are all valid methods to add an extra layer of verification using hardware, that is, your phone. Nowadays, since we always carry our phone around wherever we go, it makes sense to use it as a way to authenticate ourselves. I believe it is one of the most convenient ways of adding an additional layer of verification. This guards against things like brute force attacks, since hackers don't physically possess your phone, and hence can't log in even if they guessed your password. However, it is not completely foolproof, since as humans, we are prone to error. Some people might show notifications in plain text on the lock screen, and that in turn weakens the security. However, for someone to be physically within range to see your OTP, it is probably through some form of social hacking. So that's a whole different issue on its own. Furthermore, these OTPs are random codes that expire after a certain period of time, say 1 to 2 minutes, further increasing the complexity of hacking into your account. If an OTP sent to your phone for verification is 123456 per se, there are 6 digits to brute force. It means that if we have the numbers 0 to 9, there are 10 possibilities per digit, requiring the hacker to choose from 10 to the power of 6 possibilities. Usually, there are defense mechanisms in OTP systems as well. To guard against brute force attacks, they can put a limit on the maximum number of tries. For example, if the max limit is 3, a hacker will only have a probability of 3 out of 10 to the power of 6 to get it right. All in all, I find the password game a fantastic one. You should all go and try it out if you haven't. Even though Bill Gates once said that text passwords are dead, passwords are still here to stay for probably a very, very long time.